Welcome, gentlemen. Today we're going to be looking at financial statements, and I'm going to then introduce you to the income statements. Okay. So first thing first, financial statements. Okay, they're basically the income statements and the balance sheets, and then the notes are you'll see the notes that goes into the balance sheets that's with regards to capital. But basically, financial statements are income statements and balance sheets. Okay. So today we'll just look at the income statements. Okay. Some definitions, just to recap: current assets, assets that are converted into cash within the next accounting period, so within 1 year, 12 months. Okay, things like trading stock, debtors, people that owe us money, and cash, like physical cash, like you can see here. Okay, non-current assets, okay, buildings, okay, things like these, trucks, okay, from vehicles but not current assets, and equipment. So basically assets which are not expected to be converted into cash anytime soon. You wouldn't buy one of these bad boys and then want to sell it within 12 months, then buy another one and not want to sell it within 12 months. Doesn't make sense. Okay. So these are fixed assets, things like land and buildings, things like vehicles, things like equipment and investments, things that you keep for a long time, but things that will make you money, okay, that help you in making your money for your business. So recap on non-current liabilities, just like non-current assets, okay, these are debts that are not, that need only to be paid further than 1 year's time. So they paid over 12 months, just like non-current assets are assets that you keep for longer than 12 months. Non-current debts or liabilities or money that you owe or things that you owe that you pay over 12 months are called non-current liabilities. Then current liabilities, similar to current assets, these are debts that need to be settled in the next accounting period. So if, for example, short-term loans use you like 3 months, okay? People loan you money, you have to pay them back within 3 months, and that's within 1 year, so it's a current liability, a short-term loan. Mortgage loan, as you can see in this picture, and a house, okay? Mortgage loan is just that, okay? It's when you take out a loan to buy a house, okay? Obviously, you're not going to buy a house and expect to pay it off within 12 months, because I know you gentlemen want houses for millions and millions of rands. Okay. So let's move on to the income statement. So by definition, the income statement, it basically reflects the profits or loss a business has made during a specific time period. So the income statement will tell you that in this year, you have made this much profits or you have made this amount of loss. Okay, let's look. Uses the accounts from the nominal account section. Okay, so remember again, the trial balance is divided into the balance sheet section at the top and the nominal account section at the bottom. And remember, all the nominal account section, we included things that had to do with incomes or expenses. Okay, so it uses the accounts from the nominal account section, shows all incomes and expenses for the year. Here comes our extended accounting equation, and you can see the nominal account section and the income statements are fed from these expenses and incomes. Okay, income and expenses. Okay, it calculates the net profits or loss for a period, as we've said. That is the income statement. That's what it looks like, gentlemen. That's what an income statement, Willie's General Dealers income statement for the year ended 28 February. So they've traded the whole year, and this is what they want to see. That what is their net profit for the year? What is this figure here at the bottom? Okay, income statements is not complicated because you get all this information basically from your trial balance. Okay, so your trial balance will give you your sales and your cost of sales. With sales and cost of sales, you then get gross profits. So, okay, get a piece of paper and a pen. Let's write this down. Don't worry, I'll wait. Okay, so let's go. Sales, okay, minus cost of sales is equal to your gross profits. Okay, remember when we put the figures here aside, when you put something that we're minusing, we put brackets around it. Okay, so sales minus cost of sales is equal to your gross profits. Then you go to your trial balance and you look for your other income. Now remember, you're looking for things that are going to be like rent income, okay, commission income. You don't want your interest income because you know already your interest income is a non-operating income and therefore goes right at the bottom, okay, after your operating profits. So you look for your other income. So let's say you've got rent income because you've got a big building and you're renting out some of that building to somebody else and they're giving you rent at the end of the month. You're adding that onto your business, okay, that goes there, and you maybe get commission income from something that you sell for somebody else that's within your business, okay, and you get commission income. So you add those other incomes, and you put that figure here. So basically, if you now take your gross profit that you've made from your sales minus your cost of sales, and you add that gross profit to whatever other income you've made, you've actually now got your gross operating profits. Okay, so we're getting somewhere. What's next? Operating expenses. You then go list all the expenses that you need to run your business. Things like paying wages, paying salaries, buying stationery, buying fuel. Whatever operating expenses you need for your business, go underneath here. You add that figure up, okay? Now you've got your gross operating profits, money that you basically made, okay, from your gross profits and your other income. If you subtract that to your operating expenses, so brackets again by operating expenses, gross operating profits subtract operating expenses will then give you what you call your operating profits. So basically, if your business is operational, that's what you expect to make, okay, your operating profits. Okay, this is now the non-operating stuff that's added onto your business to either give you more money or less money. So interest income would be interest on things like your investments. So you've got an investment offshore, okay, and that investment is just making you money every single month, okay. But your business does not need to operate for that investment to keep making you money. So that's why it's a non-operating income, because one way or another, you'll still receive that income whether the business operates or not. Okay, gentlemen, once you take your operating profits and you add, obviously, income, you'll get your profit before interest expense. You then minus your interest expense. Maybe you've got an overdraft at the bank and, you know, you have to pay interest on that. Then minus your interest expense and you finally get your net profit for the year. Simple enough. Sales minus cost of sales is equal to gross profits. Gross profit plus other operating income is equal to gross operating profits. Gross operating profits minus operating expenses is equal to operating profits. Operating profits plus interest income is equal to profit before interest expense. If you subtract, interest expense, you finally then get.